Can we use more than 10% of our brain?
From students just ahead.
Is milk truly good for you?
I see you're drinking 1%. Is that because you think you're fat?
Will an apple a day really keep the doctor away?
An apple a day keeps the doctor away.
What?
This is Your Body On, 10 Body Myths Debunked. Number 10, milk is good for you and your bones. We've all heard it. Drink your milk for strong bones.
Chris, drink your milk. It'll make you big and strong.
No! No more milk for him, Lois. He's had enough. Give me that.
It makes sense, doesn't it? Milk is a great source of calcium, and calcium improves bone strength. So drinking milk helps with all this, right? Well, not exactly. Control trials have shown that having more dairy can increase bone growth in children, and it can slow down bone loss in adults. But studies have also shown that drinking more milk does not mean stronger bones. It might actually be the complete opposite.
I can't wait to drink this stuff until I'm dead.
Two large-scale studies conducted by Swedish researchers in 2014 found that more than 3 glasses per day isn't any better for you than 1 glass, and it could even harm you. They linked the extra dairy to increased odds of broken bones, though they found that more cheese and yogurt led to a lower rate of fractures.
Say cheese.
Cheese? Yes, please. I'd love me some cheese.
My wife makes this cheese.
Very nice.
Number 9. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. The phrase first appeared in 1913, derived from an English proverb that went back to 1866. It said, eat an apple on going to bed, and you'll keep the doctor from earning his bread.
I just want an apple!
Apples are good for you. They provide much-needed fiber, antioxidants, vitamins, and minerals. But can eating one keep you from needing a doctor?
Now just hold still, this won't hurt him again.
No. Statistically, there is no difference between how often apple eaters and non-apple eaters need medical attention. Although it has been found that people who eat apples are less likely to need prescription medication. Maybe we should change it to, an apple a day keeps the pharmacist away. Number 8. Humans have 5 senses. We've all been taught that we have 5 senses: touch, sight, hearing, smell, and taste. And we talk about having a 6th sense when we know something before it happens. But scientists now say that we have at least 21 senses, and perhaps as many as 33. These include such things as pain, hunger, and color vision. There are even some that only some people have, like being able to use echolocation to see in the dark like a bat. And yet there's still those who seem like they have none. Oh, that's gotta hurt. Number 7. Wait an hour after eating before swimming.
Ha! Now I gotcha! Now y'all have to wait 1 hour before you go swimming.
When you eat, blood is redirected from your muscles to your stomach to help you process the food. This leads to less blood flow in your arms and legs. That means you could cramp and drown, right? Wrong. Yes, there's a higher chance of getting heartburn or throwing up if you take a dive shortly after eating. But you've got more than enough blood in your body to enjoy a casual swim while you're digesting your dinner. Still, it doesn't hurt to wait a few minutes to digest a large meal before you go for a dip. Number 6. Shaving makes your hair grow back thicker. Ever notice after you shave, the new hair that grows in seems to be thicker? That's actually an illusion.
I could have sworn I just shaved.
When you shave, you create a coarse, blunt tip on the end of the hair. This makes it look darker and larger than it actually is. Once it grows out above the skin and there's no longer any sebum in your follicles to keep your hair lubricated and healthy, its cells die. It's this dead hair that you're shaving off, and that doesn't affect the healthy, growing hair below.
Come on!
Number 5. Nails and hair keep growing after death. It's possible that your hair and nails may grow slightly after you die, but that's only because they don't need oxygen to survive. Any growth would stop very soon after death. It would be so minor you wouldn't notice it. The living you has fingernails that gain about 0.1 millimeter or 0.004 inches in length per day. They need glucose to do this, and when you pass away, there's obviously no more left. What looks like hair and nail growth is actually your skin shrinking as it dries out. Number 4. Cracking knuckles leads to arthritis. Oh, that feels good. that sound is not your knuckles cracking. It's caused by bubbles in your synovial fluid bursting. That liquid lubricates your joints. According to researchers, there's no real difference in your chances of getting arthritis in your knuckles, regardless of whether you crack them or not. However, if they do hurt, there could be an underlying condition. Number 3. You use only 10% of your brain. If only we could use all of our brain's power, imagine what we could do!
How delightful!
Well, we already do.
Say what?
In 2009, researchers debunked this myth, discovering that the majority of your brain is active most of the time, depending on what you're doing. The myth dates back to a 1907 paper that argued people only use part of their mental capabilities. Number 2. You have to sweat to have a good workout. Exercise that causes you to sweat a lot usually burns more calories. But that doesn't mean you need to sweat profusely to have a good workout.
You're sweating all over the place.
Oh, don't worry about it. Yeah, don't even worry about it.
When you exert yourself, your body temperature rises, and your body begins to sweat as a way to keep it from overheating. But the amount you perspire is not directly related to how many calories you burn. It comes down to your body type, your hydration level, and the amount of physical activity. If you are regularly active, you may sweat less than someone less active. That's because it can take an active person more time for their core body temperature to rise. Number 1. Hot water removes more germs. The US Food and Drug Administration has stated that you can better kill germs when you wash your hands with soap and warm water. They even require food service companies to have a standard water temperature of 38 to 42 degrees Celsius or 100 to 108 degrees Fahrenheit. However, some research suggests cold water may work just as well. A 2017 study even found that there was no difference in the number of bacteria when hands were washed in water that was between 38 degrees Celsius or 100 degrees Fahrenheit compared to 16 degrees Celsius or 61 degrees Fahrenheit. Still, I prefer using warm water. I hate cold hands. Now that we've separated myth from reality, you might be interested in some of the rarest body features that make each of us unique. We'll have a look at those on another episode of Your Body On.